human beings have been breaking bones long before there have been orthopedic surgeons fixing them. So bone has tremendous capacity to heal. Our job as orthopedic surgeons is to make sure that they heal straight in proper alignment and heal in an environment where function can be maintained during the healing process. That doesn't always happen. One of the biggest challenges we have is taking care of these problem fractures and problem injuries that don't heal as expected for whatever reason. And there are a lot of factors that play into that. We see a fair number of very difficult fractures and things that are at risk for either not healing, healing slowly, or requiring multiple sort of stage procedures to get a desired result. My personal area of interest is in taking care of chronic nonunions, malunions. Those are, I guess for lack of a better word, fractures that don't heal straight. So there's a lot of challenges to overcome when you see patients that have a fracture that perhaps they've been dealing with trying to get healed for sometimes years. And you have to sort out all of the factors that have led to this, what we call a non-union. It can include addressing some of their underlying medical issues, making sure that they have an adequate sort of soft tissue envelope at the area of the fracture, and that involves involving our plastic surgery or our upper extremity orthopedic colleagues to perform free tissue transfers or other types of soft tissue coverage procedures. We have to always rule out an occult infection in the setting of a slow healing fracture, and that's not always easy to do. These can be very difficult to diagnose, and once they're diagnosed, they can be difficult to treat. So it ends up being a very complex algorithm to work through. Patients have hardware failures that then go on to heal in a malunited position. So we see patients referred from outside and occasionally from our own practices that will heal with malalignment, what we call a malunion. Sometimes those are also nonunions as well. So they can be a nonunion malunion, or they can be a healed fracture in bad alignment. If you think about the fact that if something has been crooked for many, many years, again, the soft tissues tend to drive the outcomes in these situations. So on one side of the fracture where things are shortened, if you have to lengthen that tissue to get the bone straight, you may also put nerves and arteries and other structures at risk. So all that has to be taken into account as you plan these repair of these malunited fractures. We may not have seen everything, but we've seen almost everything. And so we have lots of different arrows in our quiver, things in our armamentarium to address the same problem through different means, because not every approach is going to work for every patient. And so we really have the experience and the expertise to deal with the worst of the worst. But I can tell you it's also one of the more rewarding things that we get to do in taking care of patients who have perhaps been struggling with a problem fracture, a non-healed fracture for months, if not years, and you're able to get them through that and over the hump and back to a functional, rewarding life.